The U.S. Army's AH-64E Apache attack helicopter proved it still has a pivotal role to play, not just as a tank killer, but as a frontline counter-drone workhorse. In a series of live-fire tests such as Operation Flyswatter, the Apache version 6v6 demonstrated a remarkably high kill rate against unmanned aerial systems, UAS, showing that legacy platforms can rapidly adapt to the challenges of modern, drone-saturated battlefields. The V6 designation refers to the latest software, hardware, and systems enhancements to the AH-64E model. With minimal upgrades, the Apache is earning a new identity: multi-role attack helicopter and mobile anti-drone air defense node. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. Army's Apache AH-64E is proving to be great anti-drone platform in tests. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Operation Flyswatter, held at MCAS New River in August 2025, was a live-fire exercise orchestrated by the U.S. Army and National Guard to assess whether the Apache V6, using only existing software, sensors, and weapons, could reliably detect, track, and destroy small and medium-sized drones. The results were striking. Across multiple runs, Apache crews achieved 13 successful kills out of 14 drone engagements. Observers called this rate a clear signal that the helicopter is capable of carrying out a formal counter-UAS mission. The weapons used were diverse: Hellfire missiles, both RF and semi-active laser variants, the Joint Air-to-Ground Missile, JAGM, laser-guided Hydra 70 rockets via APKWS kits, and the 30mm M230 automatic chain gun. In effect, the Apache showcased a multi-layered engagement toolkit: heavy missiles for long-range or high-value drones, mid-range rocket attacks, and quick-response cannon fire for close-in threats. What makes this particularly noteworthy is that Apache crews needed no major hardware modifications or exotic new systems. Their familiar sensor suite, radar, electro-optical IR sensors, and targeting optics, combined with existing weapons and data links, including Link 16, was enough to deliver the performance. For years, drones have changed the calculus of warfare: cheap, proliferated, and increasingly lethal. Ground-based air defenses, even advanced ones, face limitations in coverage, mobility, and reaction time. Apache V6 now bridges that gap. It merges sensor reach, firepower reach, and mobility, providing what the Army describes as a mobile counter-UAS shield. The U.S. Army's decision to designate Apache V6 as a core counter-drone asset and to update doctrine and training to reflect that role is no accident. The results from Flyswatter and similar tests show that older platforms, when updated correctly, remain lethal and relevant in new era conflict. Apache has several advantages as an anti-drone platform. Let's look into those. 1. Small drones, and whether loitering munitions, reconnaissance UAVs, or armed quadcopters, come in many types and sizes. Engaging them effectively demands flexibility. The Apache V6's mix of weapons makes it versatile. Its ability to respond swiftly and flexibly at different ranges makes it ideal for protecting maneuver units, airfields, or frontline formations. 2. Apache V6 isn't the same helicopter that entered service decades ago. It now carries an upgraded longbow radar mast, or optionally a MUM-TX unmanned teaming mast, modern electro-optical infrared sensors, and advanced avionics. In the drone tests, these sensors detected small radar and visually small targets reliably. The longbow radar, long used for ground and air target detection, proved capable of picking up small, low-flying UAS, a critical ability when drones fly low, slow, and stealthily. Moreover, with Link 16 network connectivity and modern data links, the Apache no longer fights alone. It can receive drone tracks from ground radars, UAVs, other helicopters or ships, and share its own sensor data in near real time, making it a flying node in a broader kill web. That integration compresses the sensor-to-shooter timeline, meaning an Apache can receive data, cue weapons, and engage in seconds, which is often all the time you get when countering swarming drones. 3. Unlike fixed ground-based air defense systems, Apaches are mobile, fast, and deployable. They can relocate quickly to threatened sectors, reposition as the battlefield evolves, and cover wide areas. In drone-heavy combat zones, or forward-deployed bases, that mobility matters. The Apache gives commanders a flexible air defense shield that can move with maneuver units, provide overwatch, or guard high-value assets. Especially for expeditionary forces, airfields, or mechanized brigades in motion, where permanent radar and missile batteries might not yet be in place, the Apache offers a plug-and-play, high-readiness solution. Based on these results, the U.S. Army is reworking Apache doctrine. Counter-UAS has become a mission-essential task for attack helicopter units. Training manuals will be updated, new gunnery and engagement procedures developed, and joint operations with ground-based air defenses standardized. Further, the 2025 $4.7 billion contract awarded for new AH-64E units and associated gear reflects a long-term commitment not just to anti-armor or strike roles, but to counter-drone and integrated air defense missions. As future upgrades, sensor improvements, better rockets, potential drone-launched effects come online, the Apache's relevance may only increase. Its role could expand beyond helicopter attack to become a flying node in a layered, multi-domain defense net. The live-fire tests make a compelling case. The AH-64E Apache V-6 is more than an aging attack helicopter that once hunted tanks. It is transforming into a flexible, deployable, and highly capable counter-drone platform, one that meets the high kill ratios, combined with existing weapons, sensors, and networking capabilities, show that the Apache remains relevant. In a battlefield saturated with cheap drones, loitering munitions, and asymmetric threats, the Apache V-6 offers speed, flexibility, and firepower. It protects troops, secures critical assets, and integrates with broader air defense and surveillance networks. For the U.S. Army, and potentially for allied forces, that makes the Apache V-6 not just a stopgap, but a key pillar of future air defense doctrine.